Assalamualaikum dear students. Today my topic is about respiratory system. First we will know about the respiratory system. Respiratory system helps us to inhale oxygen and exhale carbon dioxide. Now we will learn about the parts of respiratory system. Parts of respiratory system. Parts of respiratory system. Now the first parts of the respiratory system is that is nostrils. Nostrils. It helps us to inhale air. First the air goes into the nostrils. There are present the hair-like structure known as cilia. It stops the dust particles go inside to the nasal cavity. Now the second part of the respiratory system is that nasal cavity. Nostrils lead to the nasal cavity. Nasal cavity, in the nasal cavity there is a mucus present that moistures the air. Now the third part of the respiratory system is that is pharynx. Pharynx is that part of respiratory system which connects to the nasal cavity to the trachea. Fourth part of the respiratory system is that is trachea. It's also known as the windpipe through passes to the lungs. The trachea is divided into two parts. Left bronchus and right bronchus. These bronchi are also divided into tiny branches known as bronchioles. At the end of the bronchioles, there are present air sacs known as alveoli. Like this alveoli, there are present tiny blood vessels from the alveoli. The oxygen which we have inhaled that enters the blood vessel and the carbon dioxide goes in the alveoli and goes back from the bronchioles, the lungs, bronchus, trachea, pharynx, nasal cavity and is exhaled by the nostrils. Now I will draw the structure of the respiratory system. First, then these are nostrils, then is the nasal cavity, then a pharynx, then is trachea. The trachea is divided into two parts, known as bronchus, left bronchus and right bronchus. Then are the lungs. These bronchus are also divided into at the end of the bronchioles, there are present air sacs like. They are known as alveoli. There are present tiny blood vessels. The carbon dioxide enters the alveoli and the oxygen goes into the blood vessel and back to the this and exhale to the nostrils. I will show you a video related to the respiratory system.
Through nose is better as mucus and hairs in the nasal cavity can filter out lots of dirt from the air. Then the air enters trachea or windpipe through pharynx or throat. This pharynx has one more opening which leads to food pipe. Whenever air enters it, stomach sends it back as burp. Now air passes through the windpipe, then the two bronchi which forms many narrower branches called bronchioles. Small air sacs or alveoli receive the air and oxygen from air diffuses into blood through thin wall of blood capillaries during the diffusion process. Blood cannot exchange gases absorbed in water in this arrangement, hence we can't breathe in water. How do we breathe the air out? The diaphragm moves downward, creating space for the lungs to expand, decreasing the air pressure in lungs. When diaphragm moves up, putting pressure on the lungs, then the air from the lungs moves out of the body or gets exhaled. Taking the reversed path, that is, bronchiole, bronchi, windpipe, pharynx, then nose or mouth. we do this process, that is inhaling and exhaling 12 to 20 times per minute.
That's all about my today's topic, respiratory system. Thank you, Allah Hafiz.